Okay, so are we again? And now it's against Veigar. So this is just like against Kesselin. You are stronger early, and you can push him in. You can harass him on the tower. The difference is he is ranged and he has his Q, so he can get more CS on the tower than Kesselin can. However, or he can do it from a little further away, so it's harder for you to harass. However, it's still your game plan is still to push to harass him and to not get ganked by warning. Since you're not against the Rammus but against the Hecarim, who is way stronger early and who's way more dangerous to gank you. So, kind of hopefully, they will punish you more than the last game, since it's kind of the same game, except that the jungler is way more aggressive and Veigar is a little bit better and is a little bit more useful a little bit earlier than Kesselin. And your jungler is Vi, who's also more aggressive than Yi, also stronger early. So it's two aggressive junglers against each other, which is snowbally. This happens this time you don't water, they walk. Let's see. Okay, you are standing here, but since no one stood here, they. If they cheese this. So you warded, and. Let's see, Vi does her red. So you want to hit the mains as much as possible. So again, the mains were low at the same time, which forces you to use Q. And bot lane knows that they didn't leash. Top lane knows that, oh, my top lane was gone, so he probably leashed. So you should all tell your jungler to steal this blue buff. If you should push and move bot, if it's team play. You should push as fast as possible and tell your Vi to contest his blue buff. Or at least after this camp, at least move to Scuttle, since Scuttle should be free if the jungler stops side, the Hecarim. And when Hecarim is spotted on this ward, Vi can also steal blue buff. But they go for a Cheese King top lane. Mundo doesn't expect it, but he flashes and he's out. And this should be pinged, like ping, 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 ping. Yeah, it's pinged. And for you shouldn't be afraid if you play bot side since Vi is there. She isn't going to blue, but at least she does Skittle. And there's no reason for you to be afraid. You got a ward here which spots him very early. And you should be afraid when the mains are on the tower, but not when it's still in the lane. Then it's really important to try to push it. Nice. So okay, at least five punished. Nice hook for Blitzcrank. So. For you, what's important this game, Mundo is always useful and it's not really worth any resources. But your Vayne is fed by now, so hopefully he can continue to be fed. But this tells you, okay, my bottom side of the map is stronger. And if Vi plays correctly, she will stay. She will continue to play bot side and gank only gank mid or bottom. And you can think about, okay, my bot side is stronger. So wave is on the tower, that's nice. You got Scuttle vision. But not a lot of vision anywhere else. Hitting tower again is not really useful, but hitting the minions is. And when I, even though you're pushing, he still has, yeah, kind of evens, he has maybe a little bit more even. Yeah, like, if you want to hit mains, you can hit the mains which are full HP, without causing all the mains to be... Okay, so for example, these two minions, if your main, the enemy still has minions to fight this, Veigar can hit this main or this minion, probably this one, to make it low and start a push. But if he hits this one, then the other mains can kill it. So like you're missing CS because you want to push, so you want to hit minions. But or you're hitting one which causes a lot of minions to be low at the same time, or you're hitting the one which is quite low, which causes it to be killed by your own minions. And both of those situations causes you to miss CS while he is just getting his AP, and for him every CS is valuable, and for you it's like you should win the push, you should get the pressure, and like this is good because you got all the minions and now the lane is pushed, and you see that here he's kind of struggling. Also again, this ward against the Hecarim is just not deep enough. Especially with when he activates Predator, spotting him here is too late. It gives you a false sense of security. But what does give you security is the Vi being here. So now you can play topside and keep an eye on the Vi, because Hecarim is coming. And Hecarim should be dead. Flash auto. Nice. That's really good that you play topside and kept an eye on the Vi and you punish Hacker, which he's very behind. Vi can take Crocs, and if she does, she's a camp ahead of Hacker, three assists ahead, and Hacker should be kind of useless this game. She needs to build right now. This is taking too much. Hacker is... So Hecarim is spotted again, topside, here. And you need to back off. He's baiting you with that recall. But he's only level, well, he's only level 3 and he doesn't have mana, so... You're fine. He doesn't kill you here. Okay, so again, the situation... When Hecarim is spotted on this ward, this is a good ward. He's really weak, but let's just say again it was like Extensor or something, or maybe even Hecarim, which wasn't this behind, like level 5 or something. Then here you should know, oh, he can come towards me, so I should back off. It's fine because the wave will crash in the middle anyways, like, yeah, a little bit towards them, but you should give up until you spot him again. But since he's such lower mana and he's so weak, you can do this, but I don't think you really realize this. So I don't think the reason you push is not because... I think the reason you push is not because you know you can 2v1, but I think it's just because you want to pressure him, and I don't think you realize that Hecarim is coming towards you if he's spotted here. But yeah, the fact is, you can't do anything, but he does get you low, and you can just get Lost Chapter. The wave is pushed anyway, you can back for Lost Chapter. Don't try to cancel his back, it's baiting. Yeah. And now you should back. So again, if Hecarim realizes this, you are dead. Right, what happened? He can't do anything. Yeah, but he shouldn't contest these minions, so it's good that you got this flash, but
It was whiskey. And now you spot Hecarim top, so yes, you can push, but it's better to back off even before you ulted in, since you got enough gold for last chapter. And he's lower mana, so he had to back, and those two minions that he got doesn't really matter. So Hecarim is getting killed topside, but it doesn't really matter. Mundus still had in CS. And you got Dragon. So Vi is playing towards your strong side, the bot side, and Hecarim is just trying to get himself ahead by going topside. And that's fine for your team, since Dragon is more important than the blue buff. So you're going into lane with this. And he also has lost chapter already. Yeah, the wave is really big, so you should just thin it out. And you don't have kill pressure yet, because your ultimate is not up, but your ignite is. You can still chunk him if he walks up. Again, this ward doesn't really do anything, and your Vi is here. So, you know he's not there because the Vi is there, so you can focus on this wave. So you're throwing the Q, but you're letting yourself get, like, you shouldn't be afraid of the Viger. If he walks up, you can trade with him. You're stronger. You don't need to give up the cannon. You're a level, you got a level on him, and your burst is just way higher, your ignite is up. You kill him, so there's no reason to be afraid. Vi was also close. It's only dangerous when you're here on the tower. Then Hecarim is dangerous, but not when he's behind. So now you roam bot without pushing mid. So this roam is probably successful. Yeah, the roam is really clunky. But it's good that you tie the roam, but it's even better if the wave is pushed. But it's good that this game you decided to roam and help your team. So again, you can just walk here. Hecarim was spotted here. They know that he was here. He was there. So you could run to mid, and if you spot them, you can chunk him a lot. Don't really full engage on him, because if you get stunned, he can kill you, but you can walk here and force him to walk away. So kind of the same thing with spiders. He's more afraid of you than you are of him. At least it should be the case. So again, you push and you're looking for something. Maybe you tried to roam. At least it's good that you walk it out of vision, because it forces them to assess, but they knew you weren't gonna roam since bot was pushed and top lane was gone. But there are cases where you can push and then walk out of vision, which causes them to be scared. Right now there are a lot of phases where he is pushing, so he gets a lot of CS, he gets a lot of gold, and that's kind of dangerous. Yeah, Hecarim is getting himself back into the game, which is also dangerous. And you can push. You should just start the team back off. But Hecarim gets hooked.
This fight is really bad. Okay, your perspective. You're here, you see Vigo missing. So bot lane got the kill, but they fucked up tremendously. And you know Hecarim is there, so two of them. And you say, okay, Vigo missing. You can push mid and tell the team, okay, back off, there's nothing to gain here. You don't need the kills, you're already stronger. Fighters need the kills, she's also strong, but if they get kills, it's dangerous for you since they skill super hard. So you walk in here. This hook shouldn't have landed, but fire should have hit Q. There are a lot of mechanical mistakes, that's why Hecarim doesn't die and Vi does. And in the end it's a 1-for-1 where Viger gets a kill. And I think you get a kill. And the kill on Viger is more important. He's at 141 AP and you're only at 100 since because of his passive. Since this is also not needed, you know they are back. So you should push and then back. And then you get full HP, so there's no reason to... I see. What? Yo! Oi! And if you were earlier and the wave was pushing on the tower, you could have backed for free, but after this wave, you can still back. Yeah, you have 2000 gold, you should always back. Bot lane is kind of throwing the lead, but it's fine. Vayne still skills a lot. Oh, he was cancelled. Nice. Well, backing, I think just spamming more if I was missing. If just spamming, not really on them, but spamming the river. And that hopefully causes them to back off. Instead of just assessing mid, because then they think, oh, that's so far away, he can't be here. But spamming maybe like boom, 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 boom. Like for example, when you spotted Hecarim here, you also didn't think he was gonna go mid. And that the same case when you ping mid lane, they don't think he's coming both. And this is just Vayne spotting. So even though Vayne is throwing the lead, she's still a strong champion. And you can do more, the Viger is free farming now. You can kill him, you got Ignite up and Ultimate up, as long as he doesn't get a Q and Ultimate on you. Or W. It's fine to get hit with Q but not with W. This way you can kill him. He's dead. Probably shouldn't take the kill, that's fine. And you should help Dragon. Like again, hitting the stairs is not important. But Dragon is... Yeah, even plating is fallen, so there's nothing to gain on the tower. Dragon is way more important. So Vi is playing this as well as she could. Hecarim is dead. She get hooked, this is very huge for you. If you went to Dragon earlier, Vi wouldn't have died and the rest would probably be the same. Like there's no reason to attack this tower at this point. And let's see how much gold you have. Yeah. It's at least enough for boots. So again you can push and back. Nice, you got first third. See, but now he's there's nothing he can do. There's so much time in between waves now, with two mages who can almost one-shot the wave. that a lot of times you can back for items and just be stronger. So now Vayne is playing really well, she got the kills. Should get a pink bot again. You don't have pink. You have it in your inventory, learn to use it, and when you just place it, and then you get also, you also get better at the timing. If you never, or if you almost never buy the pink wards, then it's really, and then you also don't use them well. But if you do, then you see, oh, it's for them here, oh look, it's useful. The top tower is probably just gone, and that's fine, because top tower is not that useful. Okay, 5 kills and then the top tower isn't gone. You leave while he is pushing. And top lane is not really anything to gain, the kill on you is not that important, but Veigar can free farm and get mid tower. And mid tower is more important than top. Like, you get a kill, okay. But it's better to roam while you're pushed. Your bot lane right now is okay, that happens. Holy shit, they're bad. So this game, in contrary to last game, you try to roam, but you always do it while getting pushed in, and that's really dangerous. Also, bot lane should never die by. Bot lane should have never died here. It's unfortunate. So now the Veigar is getting strong. Jinx is getting strong, but Vayne is still a lot ahead. And even though you're ahead, Veigar has one shot potential right now. He's level 11, he's rank 2 ultimate. So Mundus coming in, he doesn't give fuck. This is bad for you, outnumbered. Vayne shouldn't come bot. There's no reason for Vayne to be bot. He should be top, playing for Harold. Hakim can kill. No, I can't kill Vayne on my own. On his own. Veigar's backing, so push as hard as you can. And you might get mid tower. Yeah, you do. So mid tower is really valuable. Vayne is smurfing the silver, guys. Holy shit, she did. So after this, Harold is up, but not for a long time. He has so there's no reason to be bot, since you cannot get realistically get this tower. But your goal should be Harold and top tower. Top tower because it's easy gold, and Harold because you can maybe get another mid tower or something later. And it gives you a lot of pressure to just place it. But instead you are in the lead as a team, yeah, quite a lot. But if you just use it on farming waves and staying in lanes, that's the wasted potential. Because a lead means less and less. The difference between 2 and 2.5 items is a lot less than 1.5 items. Let's see, you have an Oblivion Orb more than he has. For example, if you get Lunas Echo and he just has Lost Chapter, that's a big difference. And now the Oblivion Orb versus no Orb is already less. And after this, if you both get Modern Omicron, then it means even less and less and less. So this gold lead is good that you have it, but you should use it as a team. Indeed, via starting Harold. So you should push and help Harold. Just think that you're going to help. Your bot lane is also close. And as a team, you're still way stronger. Again, this ward is not really useful, especially now since gaming phase is over. This ward doesn't spot anything. It should be in his jungle. This is, you don't see anything here, or you want to spot him as early as possible. Vayne is going to Herald. And also Infernal is spawning. So after this Herald, Infernal is the goal. No longer top tower, since it took multiple minutes to get the Herald. But it's... Wait, is it... Okay. This is Infernal, but it's Ocean Drake, so never mind. Ocean Drake is not important. Then the goal is still just the towers and the tempo out of that. It's good, you should ping your team. Like, you only assess, but they are fighting. So they can't possibly notice that. So you should spam ping them that Viper's coming. So then... Yeah, they ended here, but... You should spam ping them, hey, Viper's coming, Viper coming, Viper coming, and then probably they notice. And you can probably follow, since if you spot Viper, you kill him. And if you don't, you still quite fast with your ultimate. You probably kill Hecarim here, nice. But this situation is not just, oh, my team in the top lane. It's also, like, one SS is not enough. They are fighting. They hear a lot of things. You're spamping. Let them fall back. And you can also follow the Viger. You are still stronger in the team fight than he is. And right now he has more... He is more useful to the team. Even though you're 6-0. He's also 3-1-3. He's also strong. And if he has more impact... that causes a lot of problems since he outscales. You're A-ramming mid lane. So things you can do. Baron is not one of them. Mid tower is 3/4 HP and top tower is low. Well, bot, there's nothing to gain. Mundo can hold off against Swain, but not really push and not really kill him. So you don't really have a strong split pusher, except maybe you. And... You have a Blitzcrank and Aoi, so you can catch them with Charm or Hook. But it's quite a problematic comp you have with not a lot of upsides. How far is that? Yeah, if I shouldn't do this. You should also realize that you have nothing to gain anymore. The only thing you can do is push minion waves. They just have more people, and that's why they're stronger. So it's unlucky that you die and give up 1,000 gold bounty. So see, before Vi died, you were up almost 5,000 gold. And then Vi died, okay, that's her fault. And now you are with 2, well, Vayne is coming. Oh, wait, Vayne is not even coming. Vayne is just gone. And Blitzcrank is also in the river, so it's 2 against potentially 5. It's 4 and then the 5th is coming. But you shoot this back. And Blitzcrank is going in, that's his fault. But it's your fault to try to do something and ult in. And now the gold is only 2,000. Plus, they probably get this tower, which is even... Wait, they're going to the Baron, of course. So if you didn't die, if you were still on the third, they could not do Baron, I think. If you still had ultimate up.
and you could have pushed the wave, so this tower wouldn't be gone. And they can't just do Baron if you're up. Vayne is gonna 1v9 this. What the fuck? So now they have Baron and they are even in gold. And Vayne and Jinx are both really strong late game AD carries. Well, I think Morgana kind of outskills Blitzcrank, since Blitzcrank is only useful because of his hook ultimate E. But Morgana is more reliable, she can her ultimate. I don't really know who's more useful. I still think it's Morgana because the Black Shield also prevents engages. Veigar hard outskills you. His cage can zone off an entire team while you only have your fringe charm to catch someone. Well, he has a big cage and he can also one shot. Hakim and Vi also both equal late game, I think. But Swain also outskills Mundo, so now it's ahead and getting into late game, that's a problem with all Viker's power. And I think the game is kind of getting out of hand if they group. There's not really you can do. Nothing really you can do as an individual. But the laning phase, you could push more, get more last hits for more gold. Back earlier when the wave is pushed, there are more backing opportunities, so you're stronger at more times on the map. If you sit on 2000 gold, you're not useful. But if you spend that, if you go to item spikes, for example, Lost Chapters and item spike, Ludens and item spike, your boot upgrade, those are spikes. Okay, nice. Where you shoot really back, but also when the wave is pushed and you can get like an M-tone boots, pink ward, that's also when you should consider backing. Since hitting tower early is not useful. And then later on you can push more, harass more, and place more deep vision. So when you spot Hecarim earlier, for example, your bot lane was really ahead. And when you place a ward, for example, here or here, and you spot Hecarim there, you can spam ping him, so your bot lane can play more aggressive. So that's why you can use your matchup advantage and your push advantage to help other lanes just by knowing, hey, Hecarim can't gank you, so you can go ham. And again, this is in team play, it's even more important, but even in solo queue, if you're spamming a jungler, they know, okay, the jungler is not there. You cannot prevent them from inting if the jungler is ganking, but you can give them information, oh, he cannot gank. He 100% cannot gank. So, that's something you can do for your team. But now they just have Baron, Vayne is probably tilted and also really bad. QSS too early, lol. And this is just you're getting choked. And giving up these skills is not necessary. You should stand here and maybe defend 2-3 waves. Then this hour will be gone, but this is fine. Again, turtle, and hopefully they don't get an inhibitor out of the Baron. Instead of contesting the wave all the way here. Again, you're fighting in front of the tower. And that is too fired. And now you also die and they get the tower in one wave instead of 2 or 3. It's not like, oh, they have Baron, so we should engage. No, it's like, they have Baron, so we should turtle and hopefully not lose on tower base. Because Baron already expired. Even with all the fights and ends, they still only got one turret. So I think if they didn't fight, they literally didn't get anything out of this. But now Vayne is just being a Vayne. Okay. This game should be over, but it's not because Hecarim decides to push. And Viger is jungling.
Like, what the actual fuck? You don't have pink in inventory. Like, those sketches are good, but there's nothing on the map to gain yet. This is a mountain on the funnel. So now you kill him, but you just back since there's nothing to gain. And the only thing you do is stop their momentum, but it's really hard to get momentum back yourselves. That opportunity is lost. Also, yes, right now your inventory is full, but if you had a pink rod and you just have an inventory and you don't use it, it's also fine to sell it after and get like 30 gold back and then buy an item you want. But just have more pinks in inventory, just in case. Like, they played it horrible and Vayne played it horrible. Happens. What is... what the hell? You could have killed them. Let's see. Again, this is very minor since the game is at the point where it doesn't really matter what you do as just the mid and just the pusher. If you walk through here, like, your ultimate is not only engaged but also you can run away. So you can walk here and try to catch people on the back. But now you go here and you kind of waste one ult charge and even flash just to get in there, and then you immediately need to go out since Swain chunked you. Well, if you were here or here, you can ult here and hit the targets you want to kill, and then still have Qs to get out, still have ultimates to get out. And now you don't accomplish anything. I think you should have gotten a double kill at least, and that was maybe enough for Dragon. I had to get a dragon and get you back into the game, but again, it's just really hard. With the Vigo is now at 800 AP. And now they get dragon. They move to the Baron. If you fight, they kill you, since they have the positional advantage, they have the vision advantage. This could be... nah. I don't even think you could be the difference if you were here. In coordinated teamplay, it's the call is either to contest the Baron here or give up, but here it's very bad for them to take the fight. It's like they engage on Vayne and then you can maybe turn with a Blitzcrank hook or something. So in teamplay you should be there, but now it's like so the Q, the Vayne is kind of rage splitting. And the game is out of your hands. That's the shitty part about solo queue games. It's, there's no macro really team play after laning phase. But in laning phase, there are a lot of still a lot of opportunities for you to help the team. So that's why I'm just kind of skipping over this. Since these are all mechanical mistakes that happen, like in if right now you replaced all your players with like platinum players at least, then yes, you would have won even though you're behind in gold and even though they outscale. just because mechanical skill, but I'm just taking it like, if the players are even in skill, you lose. And that's what also happened. So that's not really that interesting. Like, I'd rather not see these fights in normal motion. And this is the final push. So even though you're 7-3, even though your KD is well, you're more than just a pusher. You can achieve more in the game than only pushing. Like, the moments you want to do more with the roams are the moments you are pushed in. Well, when you push, you kind of wait for the next wave. You can back, you can place vision, or you can roam. No, if you're pushing, you can harass him. You can get vision, you can take a good back for items, or you can roam. And if Hecarim is spotted or your vision is set up, then harassing is probably the best. If it's possible to do and if you have kill pressure. But vision is the first step. If you don't know anything, get information on the jungler. Know where he is. Then harassing him on the tower. If there are power spikes, or if you are kind of getting lower mana and health, you can take a very good back. So, for example, if he's on the tower, he's CSing just a laning phase, then you can harass. But if he chooses to back and give up minions, then you can also back for items. And you can roam when, for example, the enemy is pushing or your ultimate is up and your ignite is up. You don't have a lot of gold, so you're like, I want to fight. But then if Vigo backs off, then you can roam because you still want to kill someone. If there's nothing to gain in your own lane. And those are some missed opportunities. So even though your KD is good, there are opportunities that lie to really become the carry in solo queue games. Do more than just be a mid laner.